And everybody is set for this matchup between the Seattle Seahawks and the Kansas City Chiefs here at Arrowhead Stadium.
Back in your days when you had to take on a team from the AFC, didn't know them all that well. What was it like as we have this little interconference matchup today?
Well, I thought back in those days, Jim, we were about ready to show them what toughness and hard hitting was. Today it's a little different, but I'll tell you this NFC team, they are a hard hitting bunch.
Defense calls a timeout.
They come to the line, and it's first down. From the gun. He had it, but the hit jars the ball loose.
Good job that time, Jim, by the defender. He hit that receiver so hard, that football came flying out. That's why it's incomplete, the big hit by the defender.
Alex Smith will take it right from the center.
Here it's a second and 10. The Chiefs get a first down.
What a good job of the quarterback that time. He saw the defensive back inside the wide receiver, and he leads that wide receiver to the sideline on that corner route.
The Chiefs in the pistol. First and 10, Jamal Charles carries the football.
Well, I know it was a short run that time by the offense, but it's what it's going to do for you long term. Keep running that football, try to wear the defense down.
It's now second down.
Go running off the toss. Gets past the first wave.
What a run by Charles.
This gives an offense a lot of momentum. It gives everybody confidence. This running back, he's sitting there going, keep giving it to me, man, because I can make it happen.
That long gain sets them up here on this play.
On first down, it's back to the ground game.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
The Chiefs lined up in the pistol.
Let's go.
Alex Smith from the gun,
running away from the pressure.
Number 11 with the carry. Gain of two on the play.
Alex Smith will take it right from the center. Third and 11. Throws to the right.
Had it for a moment, but the ball is knocked out incomplete.
This defense you're playing against, they're pretty good. So it's fourth down near midfield. Punt the football.
He'll fire it out to the left. The Chiefs now move the chains.
I guess that's how we're going to be today, isn't it? We're just going to go for it on fourth down. That time they go for it and they get it. Good job.
First The offense is set at the line for the first down.
No one's going to get him now.
The 10, no stopping him, taking it all the way home for the touchdown.
When you have speed at the running back position, you can take ordinary plays and make them spectacular. That's what they did this past time. It was an ordinary run, but the running back got a little daylight and able to outrun everybody for the long touchdown run.
Chiefs getting set for kickoff. Tackles made. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. First and 10 to the ground here. And he'll try it left.
Excellent job of just picking up the first down. This offense is hot. Another first down, and they are moving down the field.
Offense lining up here after picking up more than 30 on the previous play. Wilson's got it in the gun. And Harbin with some nice hands brings in the bullet pass.
That time the pass is completed into double coverage, Jim, but the quarterback made a bad read. But these receivers, they are so good nowadays. That time in double coverage, he went up and made the catch. It's like Bill Parcells said to me once about Mark Bavaro, a very talented receiver. He goes, remember, Sims, when he's covered, he's open.
Harvin's in the slot. Second and three. Challenging the defenders to the right side. Gains 19.
It's always good when your quarterback is able to deceive the defense with good play-action fakes. That's what did it that time. Look at the quarterback. Nice fake. Defense reacts to the run, and now you throw it over the top for the easy completion.
Picks up about two. They keep fighting for every inch, every yard, as they move closer and closer to the end zone.
Now this offense, they fit perfectly with the head coach. He's a tough guy. He's a grinder. And this offense, what a job here right now. They are grinding this football, like you said, right down the field.
Defense ready in the goal line formation on this one. And it's out of bounds, incomplete. The defense is ready to plug up the middle here on the goal line.
I think the big decision is now, Jim, do you kick the football, take the 3 points, or do you go for it on fourth down? To me, you kick the football and get 3 points on the board.
Should be an easy one here. And it's a fake field goal. Makes the catch in the end zone. Touchdown.
What a good job by the special teams coach designing this play. They fake the field goal. They throw the pass down the field. Nice catch. Wow. Caught him off guard.
Inside of the uprights. The Chiefs are anxious to return the kickoff. And he spins away. First down here. Swatted right at the line.
He's such a smart linebacker. That's one of the reasons why he was able to knock that pass down that time. He diagnosed the play. He saw what it was going to be, got himself in position, and he made it happen.
Wide receivers are bunched up. Smith's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Throwing now to his left.
Brandon Browner with the interception.
Man, you're so excited as a quarterback. You get away from the sack, you get outside the pocket, and you think, oh, I'm just going to make a great play here. Well, there's nothing there to be made. And sometimes the best decision is to throw it away. The QB didn't do it that time, results in an interception.
That defensive front looks impenetrable here on the goal line. First and goal. Harvin's taking the handoff. Running to the left side. Breaks the plane. Touchdown.
That was just an awful job, wasn't it, by the defense? I mean, it's first and goal. Well, you know it's going to be a run, or I think you should be playing run. The defense not ready. They get overpowered, and they give up the running touchdown.
Got the touchdown. Got the two-point conversion. People love to go for two in this game, don't they?
Well, they do. And you know what? Now I guess you and I just can't sit here and blast the coach for a bad decision. When you pick up the 2 points, you can't complain about what they're trying to do.
Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. Setting up in the pistol on this play. Jamal Charles goes to the left. That tackle was made at the 27-yard line.
Good job that time by the offense. Power run gets him a few yards.
Lined up in the pistol formation. Second and six. And they'll give it to Jamal Charles. He'll be taken down about 3 yards short of the first. The Chiefs will go with the pistol on this play. He gets it again on this drive. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Good job by the defensive player squaring up that running back and just putting his big butt right into the ground.
And that's going to do it for the first quarter. We'll be back from Kansas City for the start of the second after the break. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. Well, we'll be switching sides with this one. Ball's going the other way.
Well, that's four plays and out for the offense, and that was bad. Bad play calling, bad play, bad execution. Go to the bench and try to rethink what you're doing.
Loading up with extra defensive backs in the dime. Wilson's going to take it from the gun. Looking for Percy Harvin, and they can't connect.
Take no chances when the football is thrown in the end zone. Don't go for an interception sometimes. You can kick the ball up in the air. Hey, don't do that. Knock it down.
Baldwin's a receiver in the slot. Wilson standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Nowhere else to go, and he's out of bounds.
Well, I guess the best thing to say there, Jim, is they completed a pass, but it still did not get a first down.
The completion sets them up now for third and seven. Secures it with two hands. The tackle was made, but the first down is picked up.
Every quarterback in the NFL loves this coverage where you got four defensive backs all playing deep. So in routes, anything across the middle, usually is wide open. Good job of the quarterback taking advantage of the defense that time.
First down and 10. He'll fire it out to the left. Forgot to catch the football.
Look the football in. With the gloves these receivers wear, the rules that you can't touch them, There's no excuse for dropping the football.
Quarters formation here for the defense.
It's up six.
Nice throw that time by the quarterback in the red zone. Gets a completion. And there's some tight spots. Not a lot of room. So you got to really drive the football in there.
Russell Wilson has it under center.
Third and three. Ball's picked off.
And he's brought to the ground.
First down, offense readying for the snap.
Charles is going to secure the football on the toss.
Going to be a tackle for a loss.
When you make play calls like that, you're not going to win many football games. That was a terrible call here on first down.
The Chiefs line up in the pistol offense.
Got a little screen set up here.
Breaks free. He's into the open. Muscles through the defender.
Well, it doesn't look like much, but it really serves the purpose. Picks up the first down, and now they have a chance to open things up.
Watch the blitz.
This play set up by the long gainer.
The throw to the left.
The Chiefs get a first down.
Anytime you get in the red zone, you want to punch it in there and get 7 points. They're being dominated today. They're down more than seven, but don't worry about it. Score here and just keep playing.
First and 10. In trouble now.
Looking to the right side and throwing. Brought down just 2 yards shy of the first down marker.
So many times we see quarterbacks get in this position. They get out of trouble, but they're so terrible throwing the football on the run, they can't take advantage of the fact that they got out of trouble. Not this time. Good throw on the run.
He had no time to get set.
Terrible job by the offensive line. Your quarterback needs more time than that. Another incompletion.
The offense needs 2 yards here on third down following the incompletion. Here's the handoff. Run, touchdown. And this game just got a whole lot more interesting.
When you're behind in the football game, drive down and score. They did that. Now the next time when they get back out there, they got to do it again. Show some patience and drive it down the field.
Get set, looking to convert on this two-point try.
So they give up the touchdown, but they do not allow the two-point play.
Yeah, good job that time by the defense. So quick and so ready for that play. They reacted very fast. That's why they stopped it.
And he fails to get out to the 20, and he is smacked down at the 15-yard line. First down on the way. Harvin's going to take the handoff now. Searching for space to the right.
Power running. A lot of teams in this league don't even do it anymore. This team, they can power it up in there and pick up those tough yards.
Second and six. And he's going to be brought down.
That's what all defensive coordinators love to see. They don't have to blitz, and one of their defensive linemen gets a sack without any blitzing.
2 minute warning.
Get,
offensive line gets in position. Can they protect their quarterback?
That catch gives them a first down.
How do you stop these receivers now? It's almost impossible with the rules of the game. Tight coverage. That time they have double coverage on him. It doesn't matter. The throw comes. They go up and make the catch. All you can do is raise your arm and go, well, we did our best.
Harvin's going to get set in the slot for this snap. Second and 12. Oh, almost caught.
Let's just tell it like it is, Jim Nance. This receiver is not a very tough guy because he gets hit. It should have been a complete pass. When he gets hit, he just throws that football on the ground, and the pass is incomplete.
On the way, third down.
Wilson's back in shotgun formation.
He brings it in. Seattle is in for the score. Touchdown.
What a terrible job by the defense. That time, nobody even covers the receiver. He is wide open down the field, and, hey, nice job by the quarterback going through his progression. He finds the open guy and gets a touchdown pass.
The point after is good.
Seahawks ready here for the kickoff.
And it's the same as a touchback as he's tackled right at the 20. Jamal Charles is in the backfield. First and 10, looking for an open receiver on the right, and gets the first down.
You know, when you throw the football like that down the field, you pick up a first down, now you can do anything you want on the offensive side, and you got that defense guessing.
They've got a first down now after that catch.
And he's almost intercepted.
Incompletion by the quarterback that time. It was good, tight, man-to-man coverage.
Second down after the incompletion.
He's looking to the right here on this throw.
Tackled down right around the 48.
Nice catch that time by the wide receiver on the slant route. Quarterback puts it right on target.
That reception gave them the first down.
Throws to the right. And almost picked off. Shotgun look here for Alex Smith. Second down and 10. Scrambling out of the pocket. Just had to avoid the sack. Incomplete.
Nice job by the defensive backs. The quarterback buys the extra time. He gets outside of the pocket, but look at them. They stay right with the pass receivers. Nobody gets open. Quarterback has to throw it away.
Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10. Looks to his left. On the money, and they advance the ball onto the other side of the field. You talk about controlling the flow of the game. Another first down, and the drive keeps on going.
Yeah, why not? The defense, they're just sitting over there. They're taking the hits and not even fighting back. It's a terrible job by the defense.
Smith's going to throw once again on this down. The Chiefs now move the chains.
Well, the corner route. Some people call it the corner route. They call it a flag, run to the flag of the end zone. Or a seven route. Odd numbers break out. That time we see a nice route by the wide receiver and a good throw by the quarterback.
Challenging the defenders to the right side. Gains 13.
Good job by the offense. They're in the red zone. They're down by more than seven. But the defense, can you stop them and just give up the field goal try?
The first half is over. And we'll be back with our first half analysis in just a moment.
We're back here now in this one, where the Seahawks lead by 10.
Shifts away. They bring him to the turf. Parvins lined up now as a slot receiver. First and 10, the quarterback will hand it off. Slashes to the left side.
He's brought down at the 25-yard line.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Second and 2. Right on the money.
On his way.
The 40, the 30, the 20, the 10. What an effort and a touchdown.
Well, the NFL, no lead is ever safe. So when you got the lead, you push it on in there, score another touchdown, and keep putting the pressure on your opponent.
Well, this works out about 40% of the time if you look back on history, and they'll go for that two-point conversion. So they get the touchdown, but they go for two and fail to convert.
I'll be the first to say it. That was a terrible decision to go for the 2 points. I'll give the defense some credit, but mainly the blame goes to the offensive play call.
Signals right away, fair catch. Tight ends, first and 10. And they'll run the football with Charles. Gains 16.
Well, when your team is behind, what do you do? Just come out there and get a first down. That's a nice job by the offense.
New set of downs now after picking up the first on the ground. Throws the pass. Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
That's a good job. He's able to get up and get off the field. And my guess is he's going to be okay. A little bit of a scare there, no doubt about it. That makes everybody nervous.
Jamal Charles is in the backfield. Charles has handed the football. Gainer there by Jamal Charles.
Find a way to score. That's always the mantra with every team when they get in the red zone. If you punch it in here, even though you're down by more than 7, it'll give you confidence for the rest of the game.
And pick up about 4.
When you get down in the red zone, the offensive coordinator's got to call a play that deceives the defense. Let's see if he can do it. His team is down. He needs a big play here.
Second and 6. Intercepted! They tackle him for a loss. They'll take it at the 20. Danielle's got an injury update for us. Let's go to her now. Let's go now to Danielle Bellini, who has an injury update.
Guys, I just spoke with a Chiefs official. They're saying it's just a minor injury, so he should be back on the field pretty quickly.
Looking to the right side and throwing. Gets it out to the 22.
Nice catch by the receiver, but it still doesn't get a first down.
Baldwin's lined up in the slot. Screen. He makes the catch. Into the open now as he crosses the first down marker. Eric Berry comes up to make the play.
Oh, I loved it when I was a quarterback, throwing screens or throwing short passes to the running backs and watch them catch it and get those big yards. It was awesome to get cheap yards like that.
Defense was trying to guess the snap count, and it cost them there. They'll take that gift from the defense and line up now with a new set of downs. Wilson from the shotgun, looking for Percy Harvin, and it's incomplete.
Someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
Always hard to guess what the injury is, but and don't like to speculate, but I think it's pretty apparent. It's an upper body injury. We'll let you know when we find out.
Miller's a tight end, but lined up in the backfield for this play. Second down and five.
The defense gets the sack.
This defense is awesome in blitzing. That time they blitz, they get the sack on the quarterback. They time the snap count perfectly and catch the offense by surprise.
Russell Wilson will take it from the gun.
Very nearly intercepted.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
Let's get the injury report from Danielle Bellini.
Guys, I had a chance to speak with a Seahawks team official. Percy Harvin's injury seems to be relatively minor, or at least it's minor enough that he'll be back on the field shortly.
The quarterback is coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time.
Man, you got to be smarter than that. You can't go for it every single time on fourth and long. There is a thing they have in the NFL. It's called a punt. Do it more often.
Offense lines up here.
First and 10.
Looking for an open receiver on the right. Pass is made, and it's incomplete. The hit jars the ball out. Failing to complete that one. So, second down here.
He's looking to the right here on this throw. Incomplete and almost intercepted.
Nice job that time by the wide receiver on the post route. He's open, but the quarterback throws it too far and misses it.
They come out in the dime package.
So now a third and 10.
That pass play picks up the first down.
What a nice corner route run by the wide receiver. He fakes the defensive back out. And look at the quarterback. He knows that little move. When he stuck it, he let him out to the corner. Nice throw, nice catch.
Now in rhythm, the quarterback drops back to throw once more. And it's Earl Thomas who brought him down that time.
Well, even though they're down more than seven here, the offense down the red zone, it'll be good for them for the rest of this game. Their confidence for the offensive coach, if they could punch this in for the touchdown.
Here's the first snap after the big play.
And it's incomplete.
Well, these are the kind of throws in the NFL, Jim. You just take for granted that if it's open, you are going to hit it. But the quarterback makes a big mistake, leads the receiver too far to the inside, and it goes incomplete.
Setting up in the pistol on this play.
Jamal Charles carries the football. Gain of eight.
That was a nice play call by the offensive coordinator running the football in the red zone, and he picked up some good yards.
Play number six coming up on this drive. Jamal Charles, middle.
Third and goal. You don't get in the end zone. What do you do now? I think you go for it. You call the right play. Give your team a chance to put a touchdown on the board.
And they'll give it to Jamal Charles for one.
Terrible game management that time by the coach. It's three downs, it's fourth down. What should you do? Well, I think you should punt it. He goes for it and puts his defense in a tough position.
First down coming up. Looking across the middle. The pass is picked off by Barry. He stacked up at that point.
When you get an opportunity like this, you want to take advantage of it. The defense did. The opportunity was there. They get a chance to intercept the football. They do. Now, can their offense take advantage of this situation?
It's first down as they head to the line.
He'll throw it over the middle.
Touchdown. That'll close the gap in this one.
You know, if you're a defensive player and you're covering a receiver down here on first and goal, you don't have to cover that much area. That's a terrible job by the defense giving up that touchdown pass.
They're going to bypass the point after, and so they convert it here on the two-point try.
Everyone's lined up for this kickoff.
And they crash into him, ending the return at the 20-yard line. First down. Hamba Ali brings the quarterback down.
When you talk about a blitz on the defensive side, it's all about timing. Disguise it to the last second and time up the snap of the football. They did it that time, and they get the sack on the QB.
Wilson's got it in the gun.
Working that left side. No one in sight. Has the grab. And the tackle is made right around the 39-yard line.
Keep the momentum on your side. You got a lead here in the second half. Nice play that time. You pick up the first down. Let's see if you can take advantage of it.
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play.
That pass was hurried.
This will be second down.
A takeaway.
That interception is strictly on the quarterback. When you make bad decisions, I don't care how good you can throw the football, the results, usually it's going to turn into an interception.
Receivers stacked up on this play.
Brings it into his body. The Chiefs get a first down.
Good job by the receiver that time. Getting that extra couple yards, gets a first down. They are marching. Let's see how the defense reacts.
First down here after the completion.
Throws to the right. Makes the reception.
That's a tackle at the 48.
Good job by the receiver running into that defense through the zone. Finding the open space and making a nice catch.
Yeah. 15 minutes to go. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Alex Smith will take it right from the center.
We are back for the start of the fourth quarter.
Flip to the outside. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Nice job that time by the ball carrier, getting it just past the first down mark. Big first down. Keep the chains moving.
Lined up in the pistol formation.
First and 10. Setting up screen. Caught.
It's Earl Thomas who makes the tackle.
The offense picks up another first down and extends this drive.
They are, Jim. They're marching down the field, and I give all the credit to the offensive line. They are dominating the defense right now.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down.
Makes the catch in open space. That'll stop the play right there.
When you can't hit the quarterback or put pressure on him, there's not much you're going to get done then. That time, quarterback had time and throws it down the field for another completion.
First down following the long play. eyeing that left side. He has the grab.
Oh, we've got an injured player on the field.
Well, that looks like an upper body injury, Jim. I think we both can tell that. And now the question is, how bad is it? You just never know.
And here we have second down.
And they'll run the football with Charles. He's going to be swallowed up behind the line.
How about the defensive line? Getting that penetration, getting off the football at the snap, and getting it done, getting in the backfield and making that tackle.
The touchdown. That'll close the gap.
Tight ends are so valuable down on the goal line. They're able to maneuver inside. Easy to get defenders to run into each other to get open to score.
Lining up now for the two. Put an additional 2 points on the board as they convert. Ryan Succop ready for the kickoff. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. Baldwin's in the slot. First and 10. Into the open flat. Bringing the play to an end.
Nowadays, it's getting harder and harder to play this tight man-to-man coverage because you're not even allowed to touch these superstar wide receivers.
Looking for a receiver on the left side here. And that's a big tackle behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, we see it more and more. Football's thrown behind the line of scrimmage. They do it that time. Nice catch, but a loss of yards on the play.
Marshawn Lynch is in the backfield. Makes the catch in the open field.
That's a terrible job by the defense in the gym. I mean, you got third and over 10 yards. You don't get a pass rush. You don't cover up down the field, and you give up the first down.
And now they'll be on the other side of the 50 after this play.
The quarterbacks and receivers in this NFL now are so good. It's so easy for them to throw and catch and just keep picking up those first downs.
Swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, the play is there to be made, but the offensive player doesn't get it done. Bad job on first down.
Harvin's a receiver in the slot. Wilson's going to take the snap from the shotgun.
This doesn't look good. We've got a player down, and he's in pain.
Well, that's going to hurt him tomorrow. There's no doubt about it. When you get hit like that, you're going to feel some of that pain tomorrow. But the good news is, I think he's going to be okay. And once he gets a little
pass, is intercepted.
Most NFL linebackers, they're borderline good enough to be a running back. And they got the hands of defensive backs. Here's a good case. What a fine catch on the interception by the linebacker.
Time is running out. The game is tied, and the defense must do whatever it can to not give up a score.
Terrible call that time by the coach. The defense was expecting run. They were up there. They were aggressive, crowd the line of scrimmage, and you just play right into their hands, and they got the tackle for the loss.
Time becoming a factor in this game.
Screen pass sticks to his hands to the 25. 2 minutes to go before this one's in the books.
Good job by the quarterback that time. Makes the decision. Throws it short. It does not get the first down. But I promise you, third and short is a lot easier than having third and long.
The jumbo set on the field.
Third and three. He fires it in there tight. That's been the story of this game. Another third down conversion to move the chains. The Chiefs coming to the line, still have all three of their timeouts here in the fourth quarter.
So many things you can do on first down, and what do you come up? You come up with that play. That was just a bad play call.
Wide receivers are bunched up. Second and 11. Gets away from the pressure, makes the grab. That picks up seven.
Teams in the NFL spend about 30-40% of their time all week long practicing plays in the red zone. So there's a lot they can do here. Let's see if they come up with something that works.
The Chiefs have saved all three of their timeouts for here in the fourth quarter. Always aware of the chains. He's got the catch, and he's got the first. The Seahawks have to take their final timeout. That's it.
Nice job that time by the defense, knowing the situation. Go ahead and let the quarterback complete the pass. Just make sure you come up and make the tackle before the first down. Good job. Fourth down coming up.
We'll take it right from the center. Jamal Charles carries the football as he moves across the first down yardage and a new set of downs.
Well, when an offense goes forward on fourth down and you don't stop them on the defensive side, you know you are in trouble, so look out for anything.
The Chiefs will use a timeout here. They'll talk it over before running a play on first down. Able to move the chains after that last run.
Challenging the defenders to the right side. Brandon Browner with the interception.
Wonderful job by the defense that time. They stayed after it. And inside their own 20, they finally come up with the play. They get the interception and they keep the other team from getting points on the board.
On first down. Drop back, shotgun formation. Under fire on that throw. Harvin's going to get set in the slot for this snap. Second and 10. Trying to work that left side. And intercepted! They pounce on it there.
Anytime you're backed up on the offensive side, the quarterback's got to be extremely careful, because if you turn it over, you're just giving points to your opponent. That time, a bad decision by the quarterback, and he throws an easy interception for the defense.
No good. An empty trip for the offense.
I think all the fans, and us included, thought this kick was going to be good, but we can see the official sign, no good. It just missed.
The Seahawks are set to return the kickoff. Across the 10, and that's about it. He's tackled at the 15-yard line.
Easy, easy.
They come to the line of scrimmage. First down.
Running back gets it on the handoff. Going to lose yards here.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense at time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
Almost intercepted that time.
I think this is one of the easier throws in the NFL. Don't make the mistake throwing it up the field. Throw it across the field so the receiver can run to it. That time the quarterback leads the receiver way too far on the post route.
Third down on the way. Unable to complete that one, and that's a very quick three and out.
He was trying to beat him along, and the defenseman tried to catch up, reached in before the ball arrived, and that is, in fact, pass interference.
Yeah, that's an easy call. You know, just think about this. We're down. You're running the race, and somebody during the middle of the race reaches his arm out and hits you. Of course, it's going to slow you down. That's why it's pass interference.
Catch is made. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Well, it was a nice throw by the quarterback that time to get just enough yards to pick up the first down.
Let's see how they back up the big play here.
The give. And here he goes. Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
I think you can just tell by the body language and the way he's acting, that is an upper body injury. Hope it's not severe. We'll let you know as soon as we find out.
No margin for error from just outside the goal line. In on the stop.
Well, they say arm strength is overrated in the NFL. I don't know who those people are. They don't know what they're talking about. It's a big part of playing quarterback. Look at that. He fires it in there in between the defenders for the completion.
The Seahawks at the line of scrimmage with their set of receivers. Touchdown, Seahawks.
Good job that time by the offense, scoring that touchdown and putting him ahead. And when you get ahead in a football game, the National Football League, it makes you